Now new at 5.
We're all embarrassed that we're even in this position.
It's UC's turn to apologize for the Crosstown Throwdown.
You know, a lot of kids look at me and say, oh, there goes Yancy Gates. And, you know, the actions that I displayed is not what I'm about. It's not what the University of Cincinnati is about. It's not what my family's about.
Senior Yancy Gates threw the punch everyone's talking about, and today he's talking about how people are calling him a thug and a gangster.
Yeah, Yates actually broke down in tears at this news conference. And News 5's Ken Brew begins our team coverage tonight. Ken?
Well, Sheree, it was a black eye for at least one player on the court, a couple more for the two schools involved. The Crosstown Shootout turn throwdown has led to player suspensions, possible litigation, and talk that maybe this rivalry needs one giant timeout.
Less than 48 hours after the brawl scene around the world, UC head basketball coach Mick Cronin brought the combatants from his team into a news conference.
These guys are here to apologize.
One by one, Octavius Ellis, Jelon Gwynn, Sheck Mudge, and Yancy Gates took turns apologizing for their part in a basketball game that degenerated into a street fight. Gates crying when talking about what is now his new image.
I'm just not that type of person. You know, a lot of people have been calling me a thug, a gangster.
Cronin was more subdued than he was on Saturday when he earned high marks locally and nationally for his comments in the aftermath of what everyone connected with his team is now calling an embarrassment.
Nobody should ever get to represent the university, in my opinion, any university, and be on a scholarship if they don't understand that it's a privilege.
Also in attendance today, UC's new athletic director, Whit Babcock, has been on the job just about a month. And he questioned today whether or not there will be any future games between UC and Xavier.
And I've talked to Mike Babinski. If it does continue, there's a lot of work that needs to be done on the front end to change the culture of that game.
Now, Cronin says the four players involved in this fight from his team will have to do more than just hone their basketball skills while they sit out suspensions. Among other things, they will be attending anger management classes supervised by the UC.